Teenage girls today are raised in a society that tells them that who they are and who they want to be are something that they should be ashamed of. Teenagers in their adolescence ask themselves the questions, who am I or what do I want to be? Unfortunately, around the time that they're asking themselves these questions, society is asking them, what do you want to do with your future? See, the thing is, society shapes girls to be perfect, generally in academics, appearance, and social activities. This can lead to massive amounts of stress, and this drive to achieve this perfection can detach them from who they really are. This is Surviving as Ophelia, a documentary in which we take the facts from Reviving Ophelia by Mary Pipher into the real world and ask several women what their opinions are on the ideas of how society treats women and how women are raised in our societies today.
Wrapped around my finger and it's so quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite nightlight. To you, everything's funny.
I think girls get a mixed message. Girls today they're shown more as in the movies and media as superheroes. They can kick butt, they can have attitude. At the same time, they still need to be pretty and soft and girly so that their boys are attracted to them. At the same time, they need to be well-educated and powerful and able to lead people. And so you get all these conflicting messages, as well as a mother. So what's difficult about receiving that message as a young girl is maybe you don't fit into one of those categories, or you don't understand how you can do all that, because really nobody can. And what happens when you are grown up with a career is you have women who, instead of supporting each other, attack each other. So maybe you're a working woman, and then you have women who say, well, you should be home with your baby. Or you have women who are home with the children, and then you have other women say, hey, this isn't, you know, the 40s anymore. Get a job. What are you doing with your life? Because you're sent so many mixed messages as a young girl, I imagine that it's very difficult to find your place and find your identity. You're told so many things you have to be in order to be successful.
You really do have this really accepted rape culture these days, where a guy can get upset if a woman says no. When a woman says no, it's, you know, opening up for negotiations. Let me see how I can change her mind. You would never have that the other way around. There's no, oh, the guy says no, that's just the end of a conversation. And it doesn't work that way for women and for girls. And that's really the expectation of society. When looking at the Steubenville rape case, there is the victim blaming and the idea of slut shaming these days that, oh, heaven forbid that a young woman have sex. Well, yeah, what do they think happens? And so the idea that, oh, she was drinking. Look at what she was wearing, so it's her fault. Change that around. Well, how does it become acceptable for any young man to say, oh yeah, she was passed out, so I raped her. Ha ha. It's really the example in that one case, and this is an extreme example, but we see this throughout society, from how young girls, young women, older women really are treated. And it's around the expectations that for man, at their word, they're taken. For women, they're not. And that really, I think, does start very early. That looking at, you know, the case of rape, it is not taught that, hey guys, don't rape. That's how you stop rape. You teach young men not to do it. Instead, the onus is always put on young women. Be careful about how you dress, about what you're wearing, where you're going, who you're with, what your behavior is.
Self-destructive things like alcohol and drugs to like kind of deal with it. I've seen a lot of girls also just like become really angry. They'll like have like very short tempers.
You see a lot of girls trying to make themselves look pretty, but when they don't, they get depressed. And they cut themselves, and they just think they're not good enough for society, and also starving themselves. That's actually a very serious thing, starving yourself to make yourself look however you want to look. Having that figure is more important than eating, I guess.
Not sure, I haven't done the research, but I've heard that alcoholism has increased among women. Certainly other signs of stress, whether it is, you know, anger or depression. Certainly there are bodily signs. All of those have increased, absolutely.
Well, there are some negative ways that we certainly see that. Concern with body image is a big one. The increase in eating disorders, in harmful activity like cutting, concerns with that. Young women have a very high incidence of suicide. Young Asian women, actually the highest incidence of any group of suicide. So certainly the harmful aspects. There are also, you know, positive ways in which, you know, young girls kind of deal and treat with these, empowerment activities and ideas, and we certainly see both of those. And again, it just fits with that same idea of the push-pull factors and this dichotomy and the polar opposites that really society kind of pushes upon young women. Young women and girls really have had, for years, and you look at any time period, there's kind of this push-pull that goes with it. There's the expectation that girls should be sweet and should be kind and innocent and virginal with that. But then there's the other side where they're also supposed to be provocative and sexy and, you know, dangerous with it. And there's that push-pull factors. And so it's almost a schizophrenic society that every young girl and young woman is faced with, is what side do they fall on, where do they go? Is it, you know, the Disney princess on one side, morphing into Miley Cyrus dancing on a pole on the other? And, like, there is the push-pull factor in both of those at all times.
Primarily, it's, like, through the media. I feel that society will... It's very secret, or it's very sly about how they put a lot of messages into the media, like, oh, you have to be this kind of body type if you want to look good, you have to wear, like, this kind of makeup if you want to look good. I mean, like, you don't have to, it's pretty obvious, it's, like, this stuff on, like, 17 Magazine, or, like, Glamour Magazine, stuff like that, is very good at influencing girls and how they feel like they need to be.
Like, television advertisements and models out there gives us a view of how girls should be, like, super skinny and super pretty, but like, it's mostly Photoshop.
Yeah.
But it just gives us the pressure that we have to look like them, and we have to just be like them, skinny. And also, like, people do all sorts of things that hurt themselves to make them look how they want themselves to look like.
I'm in a group of people that I don't really know. I feel like I have to kind of make myself more, like, toned down and less like me, because I'm not sure how they'll react. I think that for myself, I am very, very wary of how people see me, so I want to make sure that people are okay with seeing me as a certain way before I act how I normally do.
Sadly, it's when I'm, like, first meeting someone. I know I said before that I love the people that are who they are, like, they are themselves when they first meet someone, and I mean, I try to be myself, but sometimes I try to be, like, as nice as possible and as welcoming as possible. I mean, not to say that I'm not normally welcoming, but I mean, you know, more so.
Yeah.
And I try not to scare them off or anything
yeah.
like that. Like, not be too weird or be totally myself. And so mostly with first impressions.
Is there anything else that you've had in your life that's helped you maintain the confidence that you have today?
Honestly, education. Knowing that I had a great high school education, college, first master's, almost finished with a second master's, applying to doctoral programs. It's like education. Education absolutely has been central to it. And with that, there's very few arguments that someone can make about a situation which I care about and have an opinion and want to say that I haven't read about it, that I haven't studied, and that I haven't really thought about why do I feel that the way I do, and want to be able to articulate that. So education has really been central with that.
Yeah, what happens is you lose yourself. And so, again, talking with my juniors in invisibility, we talk about wearing a mask. And you wear that mask so much, it becomes who you are.
Know something now I didn't before. And all I've seen since 18 hours ago was green eyes and freckles and your smile in the back of my mind, making me feel like I just wanna know. You better know you better now. I just wanna know. You better know you better now. I just wanna know.